All right, welcome to part one of my lesson on The Resistance by Skillet. In this video, I will be teaching you how to play everything aside from the solo at the end of the song. That will be in a separate video. This song is in drop D. However, during the verse, Seth uses a drop pedal, I believe, which basically allows him to change tunings mid-song, and he drops it down to drop C during the verse, and I'll talk more about that when I get to it, but for now, here's the intro. It starts on the 10th fret of the B. It's 10-8 on the B. Pick each note twice, and then you go to G and play 10-9, 7-9, 10-7. Okay, now the chords, it sounds like this. So that's just the open D, all power chords, followed by some mutes, third fret of the D, and third fret A. Back to open. It's open three, and then open three, open. 3-5-3, and then third fret A. Alright, so, first half of the verse is just the open D string four times with a slide in between the third and the fourth time. Just like that. Second half sounds like this. So that's just the D string open, followed by 3 and 2. And then repeat. And now this is where I believe the drop pedal comes into play. I believe Seth either engages the pedal to drop down to drop C, and then he either hammers on to the second fret, or he turns off the pedal, which then raises the pitch up to a D. I don't have a drop pedal, so I use the whammy bar and push it down until I reach the pitch of C. Or at least close to it. It doesn't need to be exact, because I'm not there for long, because I push down. It's right about there. And then just let go of the whammy bar. Like so. If you do not have a whammy bar and you don't have a drop pedal, you can either ignore that first note, the C, and just play the D again, or you can do this little trick. Say you take the open A and the open D, and you ignore the low D, but you just play these two together. That sounds like an open D power chord. Not quite as punchy, but it still sounds like an open D power chord. Now both of those notes can also be found here at the 7th fret of the D and the 5th fret of the A. So if you move those two notes down to the 5th fret of the D and the 3rd fret of the A, it sounds like an open C power chord. So you can play that, followed by an open D, and you'll get the same effect. So yeah, hopefully I explained that clear enough. Now, as far as I can hear, there's nothing actually being played during the pre-chorus. However, I, in my cover, which if you haven't seen, I'll have a link to in the description, added my own little thing, which sounds like this. So that's, if you want to learn it, you just bar across the third fret of the B and the E, hammer on to the fifth fret of the E, and then pluck it one more time. And then you play the third fret of the B twice. So you repeat, and then bar across third fret, B and E, hammer on to fifth fret. Fifth fret E, third fret B, and then that's 6E, 3B, 5E, 3B, and then 3E, 6, 5, 6 on the B. All right, and now on to the chorus. Alright, I'll just play through it real fast. Alright, pretty simple, pretty common chord progression. It's just the open D, first fret of the A, all power chords, fifth fret D, and third fret A. Repeat. And then this next time through, you're gonna, and rather than playing the fifth fret on the D, you're gonna play the third fret on the D. And then you play as normal, and you end on the fifth fret of the D. And like so. Okay, so the bridge. There are no chords that I can hear during the bridge, but there's just this little solo thing. So that's just 6th fret of the B. Slide up to the 13th fret, and then go to the 8th fret of the B. And just repeat as often as necessary. Okay, so now we come to the outro. I'll play a little bit of it, and then I'll show you what I'm doing. So that's... it's actually very easy. It's, 3 open 3 on the low D, 5 3 on D, followed by 3rd fret on A, and then open D. Like that, and that's 3rd fret on the D, you play 3 2 3. 3rd fret G, and slide up to the 5th fret. You want that to be a very fast slide, by the way. You don't want to actually hear that. You don't want it to sound like this. You just want a quick, like that. Then you play this one more time. And so this is a 5th fret on the A string, 3rd fret on the A string, and then 2 on A, 5 on D, and 4 on G. And then you got... So palm mute the low D, and then 3rd fret A, play it 3 times and pull off to open, and then 3rd fret D, and bend. So yeah, that's pretty much it. You just repeat stuff in different orders. There are some changes throughout. For example, you'd play this, but palm muted. And then eventually you'll hear this. That's 3rd fret D, open D, palm muted twice. 3rd fret D, and 3rd fret A. And then the outro, towards the end of it, you got... So, first time's the same. Then you start to go through it again. And you palm mute. Open, 3, open. 3, 5. 3, open, 3, and 5. Then just 2 open chords, palm mute twice, and then 2 open chords. And that's it. I hope I was clear enough throughout all of that. I hope I didn't leave anything out. That's it for this video, and I'll see you in part 2 for the solo.